morning. Let's call to order this special meeting of the Board of Directors. Clerk, please call the roll.
Good morning. Just a friendly reminder to please turn on your microphones when speaking. Leyva Gonzalez?
Here.
Bush? Chavez?
Chavez present.
Hillard? Donovan?
Present.
Elo Rivera?
Present.
Castell?
Present.
Cobalt?
Present.
Hall?
Here.
McCann? Montgomery Stepp?
Here.
Moreno? Pepin?
Here.
Whitburn?
Here.
We have a quorum, Vice Chair.
Thank you. We're going to take public comment now. I think that we should hear all public comment before closed session. The standard agenda limits public comment to 5 speakers before closed session and the remainder after, but I think we should hear from everybody first. Is that acceptable to the board? Okay, and we're going to give all public speakers the full 3 minutes. Clerk, do we have any public comment?
Yes, we do. We have a total of 3 public comments. At the moment, we don't have the names of the public comments, but we will get started with them.
Please proceed.
Thank you. First public speaker, ending in 2899.
First of all, thank you, Chair Whitburn, for leading from the front and allowing all public comments. I was hoping there would be more participation in this important matter. Mary Davis here. I just quickly state in the obvious that this is your agency's litmus test between word and deed, aspirational values versus demonstrated values. For the past 3 years, many of us from the public in various chambers and platforms have brought forth valid criticisms of Nathan Fletcher, all which fell on deaf ears. From his mocking condescension of telecommenters at the July 2022 Board of Supervisors meeting, to his blatantly denying and lying about ever having done anything in the way of imposing vaccines on anyone, when in fact he put forth a vaccine mandate for new hires, both in October and November of 2021 at the meeting, or whether he paternalistically chastised Chaldean businessmen a few months ago when they voiced valid concerns for increased fees for tobacco sales, there were many, many times Fletcher egregiously and openly abused and mocked the public. And while he was openly abusive, both in meetings and on social media, behind the scenes, he was abusing our public trust. While he spent 3 years lecturing on us on public safety, collective obligations, and the community good, he was living a far different life from what he presented via his public persona and blurring the lines of his personal life and bringing his egregious behavior into your very own chambers there. Whether you knew of concerns or merely suspected them, too many in this chamber, on social and professional circles, and in the media, remained silent and looked the other way as a matter of political convenience. So everyone in that den of deniers isn't complicit in this episode. You now have a choice whether to circle the wagons and try to have shields up or whether to live up the values that I constantly hear about of integrity and holding up women and affirming. So I ask you to choose wisely and lead from the front with integrity. And also, I would like to say your audio format is not enough. Given the implications of things that happened in your boardroom, you absolutely need to switch to a video format for your for the archival record. Thank you so much. And again, I appreciate your integrity of letting everybody speak.
Vice Chair, my apologies. We only have 1 public speaker. That concludes public comments.
Thank you very much, Clerk. At this time, the board will move into closed session. Thank you.
So reporting out of closed session item number three, conference with legal counsel regarding existing litigation, Gracia Figueroa versus Nathan Fletcher and San Diego MTS. The board received a report from legal counsel and gave instructions and authorized a statement of the board that will be delivered by Chair Whitburn.
Thank you for that report. After this meeting is adjourned.